Welcome back to Wisconsin Family. We are filming here at Tracks Hobbies and RC Raceway. It's a brand new place over off of Todd Drive. And we're going to talk with Michael and his son, Cheyenne, in a little while about drones. So I'm really pumped about that.
I know you are.
So we're at Tracks, but actually right now we're going to head over to the doghouse a little bit. That is Doghouse University. And we're joined now by Nate Mathis Vargas. How are you, Nate?
Good, how are you?
Yeah, great. Good to have you back with us.
Thanks.
And let's talk a little bit about dog sitting, because that's a big part of what you guys do
it
over
is.
At Doghouse University. And if, let's say an owner wants to take their own dog, first of all, wants to take their own dog to a dog park, and there's other dogs there and they're interacting the way dogs often do,
mm-hmm.
it's a little bit different from how humans interact with each other. And
yeah.
so what should people be looking for? Is there anything that people should be concerned about when they're watching their dogs interact with other dogs?
Absolutely. A lot of times people get a little bit nervous when the dogs are playing because they don't know how to read the signals the dogs are giving each other. So you want to listen for the volume of the dogs while they're playing. If you notice they're playing for a while and the volume starts to get a little bit higher and higher, those dogs are kind of need a break from each other.
Okay.
When they all kind of pack together, like someone might be overwhelmed by getting, you know, two or three dogs playing with them at the same time. You want to make sure that your dog's playing appropriately and respecting the other dogs that are at the dog park. So if you notice your dog is always constantly like running to other dogs that are playing and kind of budging in, just kind of call them back and, you know, make sure that they're, you know, learning that they can play, but not like that.
Okay.
Also, you know, if your dog is tending to run toward the fence where the entry is and the dogs, you know, coming in are being greeted right away by your dog, or you notice a dog as you're going into the dog park that's right there by the fence, a lot of dogs sometimes will be there and they get a little too over excited about it.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes it might be an issue with the dog coming in that might get overwhelmed and they can react to that. So you want to make sure that, you know, your entry into the dog park is appropriate, and while the dogs are playing with each other is, you know, going well by just paying attention to what the body language and the speed of everything.
So these are things that the a dog owner should pay attention for in their own dogs.
Yes.
And watch for so that they can make sure that they're not overwhelming or triggering in some way another
yeah.
dog that comes in.
I mean, you're responsible for your dog while you're at the dog
right,
park,
of course.
And you want to make sure that, you know, your dog is social and behaves properly, and your dog isn't the one that everyone's like, oh God, why'd you bring your dog here?
Right.
So the more you pay attention to the things they're doing while they're playing, the easier it's going to be for you to be at the dog park, because it should be a fun environment for everybody.
I think the key words there are paying attention.
Yeah.
How many people are doing this when they're at the dog park?
Just go play.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, a lot of people bring toys, and there's some dogs who don't share toys very well. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, if you get your dog just to like run around and exercise with the other dogs and not bring things that's going to start a thing with other dogs, might be a better recommendation. You could play with the throw toy at home in your backyard or what have you, but those things tend to get the dogs overstimulated at a dog park.
Yeah.
So most of the tips that you gave were dogs that might be, I don't know, like you said, budging in or creating a situation perhaps. What about the flip side, a dog that's maybe anxious?
The dogs who get a little anxious, you know, they're going to be a little bit more shy, so when dogs come up, they might cower down a little bit or they might roll over. Those dogs tend to be a little bit more sensitive to the greetings, especially. So just making sure that, you know, you're telling them it's okay, you're giving them, you know, positive cues when they meet dogs, you're trying to reinforce the behavior of, you know, it's good to meet other dogs and be social. It really helps them along, because otherwise there tends to be a defense to them. They're like really like nervous about being scared or being attacked, basically,
sure.
And they will react to that. So
and they'll feed off of your behavior. So if
exactly.
you're light and upbeat,
exactly.
that'll
they,
help. Yeah.
They read body language a lot.
Yeah.
Yep. So doggy daycare is your expertise. So
mm-hmm.
let's talk a little bit about that. What should pet owners look for if they're considering getting a dog sitter or pet sitter for their canine friend?
You want to make sure, first of all, that it's not just a person doing it off of nowhere. They have no experience. So I mean, a good reputable pet sitter should have insurance for your home, and they should also be bonded. The staff that they have should be bonded, all of them, that you can make sure that they're, you know, safe to be, because you're trusting people with keys to your house and
mm-hmm.
and, you know, being there when you're not. And they should also know a lot about, you know, different medical things that could happen with your dog. They should be, you know, CPR trained. They should be, you know, understand that when you take the dog on a walk that there's, you know, leash laws and things like that. It shouldn't just be someone who just does it kind of for fun. I mean,
right.
it's serious business.
Right.
It sure
and this
can.
Is for if you want to have somebody dog sit your dog in your own home is what you're referring to.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
Or if you have them, if you want the person to take the dog with them to your house too, that the person has, you know, a home that's safe for your dog.
Right.
I mean, we do meet and greets with dogs before we meet them, just so the dog gets to know the caretaker, especially if they're not ones that we normally have at daycare, because it makes the transition from their people to us a lot easier if they see us meet their people ahead of time. It gives them a sense of, oh, well, I trust you, my parents seem to like you, they've had you at our house before, and I can go with you, or I trust you to come into our house when they're not here. And that is a really big thing with pet sitting.
Absolutely.
Those little introductions ahead of time can really go a long way.
Yeah. It does. It really does.
Yeah.
Yep. So much great information, and we are out of time. Nate Mathis Vargas joined us from Doghouse University. Thanks so much for the information today.
Absolutely. Thanks for having us.
Don't go away. We'll be right back at Wisconsin Family here at Trax Hobbies and RC Raceway. Stick around.